In this episode, I'm going to show you my latest updates from my system of keeping track of networking events. Check it out. Okay, so earlier on today, I started using my own system. I wanted a system where I could keep track of all the different clubs and networking events and make it very easy to see the latest dates and put all the dates in a list so that I don't miss anything, I don't forget about anything. I'm on top of it all, right? And I started putting some events in. So I had some social things in the calendar. And there's a club called Zokit, which is a business networking event. I put a few of their things in there. Because otherwise, all the events are everywhere. Forget about them. Can't stay on top of it. So need a system, right? Now, I noticed a few things. I created this form. When you find a new club or a new event, I created this form. Now, originally, I just had the name. But then I thought, I want a kind of category, like, so I can categorize it, like if it's a property event or a social or a fitness event or just a general personal development club, you know, whatever it is, I want categories, right? And also, I want to be able to put their Facebook page, their meetup page, their home page, because I want all this for reference. Because, like, every time you've got to go and look for something, it takes time, doesn't it? You know, when you think, what was that event? What was their home page? I can't remember what date the event was on. Oh, how much was it? Where's the booking link? I can't remember. It all takes time. It all takes time, right? So we want to minimize all that wasted time and get and boil it all down to a system where everything's there, right? Okay, so let's do an example. So say that you find a new club. It doesn't have to be a networking event. It could just be a sailing club. Sailing Club Cardiff. Okay, type of event. Well, I'm just going to... There you go. I'll just call it outdoor, right? Now let's say it's got a Facebook... page.com/sailing and it's got a meetup page, meetup.com/sailing. Okay, so I submit that, and now what that does, that goes and puts it on my sheet on the list of clubs, right? So it's going to appear, there you go, it just appeared, Sailing Club Cardiff, it's in the outdoor category, and there's the links that I put. Isn't that cool? Now we've got those references, it's just so quicker to go back and find. And also, because it's in the sheet, now I can get the system to do clever stuff. I can get it to email me a list of the clubs that I haven't been to recently and put the links in front of me so I can just click them. See, that's why I prefer to have all this stuff in a sheet rather than just using a calendar, because you can do more cool stuff with it. Okay, so what happens now? Let's say you look on their homepage and you think, okay, I wouldn't mind going for a sailing or something. And you see that they've got an event coming up, open day, sailing open day. Okay, so organizations, we select it from the list. Where's it gone? Sailing Club Cardiff, okay. And you see there's an open day and it's on the 4th of Jan, 2020. Start time's 8 a.m. Okay, you get the idea, right? You can put a booking link. Right? Because you might want, you know what it's like, you might not want to book it now, but you also kind of don't want to forget about it either. So you want it all there, don't you, right? So there you go, submit that. Now, that now appears on the event list. There you go, Sailing Club Cardiff, open day, 4th of Jan 2020, 8 a.m. And if there was any links, they'd appear there. Isn't that cool, right? So yeah, I just wanted to show you those latest updates on the form. This is really usable now. I mean, if I want, what I'll probably do, I'll get all these events to create diary entries as well, just so they're in the calendar as well, maybe, or I might just not bother. I might just use the list, to be honest. In the last video, I did show you the, when you attend a club, you can put a tick in here and then it prompts you if you want to rebook, and it gives you a list of things you've already been to, a list of things you haven't. So we can later manipulate that information to get the system to prompt us to rebook things, okay? Thanks for watching, everyone.